Well, for stage three prostate cancer, and usually there's somewhat of a blurred line on that, and that's because in order for someone to be really diagnosed with stage three prostate cancer, it is obviously not only involving a prostate biopsy that has identified the prostate cancer being present, it also more than likely involves an examination which identified that there is something firm or hard involving the prostate, confirmed with the biopsy. And then, in addition, if the clinician is suspicious where maybe the cancer is extended outside of the prostate, which is really the definition of stage three prostate cancer, they usually will do some form of imaging, such as an MRI, maybe a CT scan, to identify that the borders of the prostate has been compromised and that the cancer itself has invaded into the surrounding tissue of the prostate. In that instance, I think that's a very individualized type of therapy that one has to consider, because there's not necessarily one size fits all. In some cases, in a very young individual who may have stage three prostate cancer, clinicians may advocate a more aggressive form of treatment where the prostate would be removed, knowing in light that there may be positive margins surrounding the tissue. The rationale behind taking such an aggressive step is because that particular individual could suffer some of the very significant side effects if the prostate cancer were to progress that would then occlude their urinary tract, not only as they're unable to urinate, but it can also shut off the drainage systems that go into the bladder and therefore leading to kidney failure. So even though if someone has somewhat, quote, an advanced disease, that certainly be something that we would consider doing. Now, a lot of times when you have a patient who has stage three cancer, we would consider, before we operate on them, put them on a course of treatment called hormonal therapy. And what hormonal therapy is doing is actually shutting down the production of testosterone within the patient's body. And starting from the beginning, one of the driving factors for prostate cancer to perpetuate is testosterone. And it has been found that by eliminating the production of testosterone or eliminating testosterone from the body, the prostate cancer can go into a hibernative state and actually maybe even shrink in size. And so a lot of times a clinician will put a patient on these type of therapy for 3 to 6 months and then go in and do their operation. Now, obviously, if someone is older, who is maybe not in such great health, then they may end up still having hormonal therapy, but not necessarily have a treatment where their prostate is removed. So those options would still fall back into whether they receive some form of radiation in that area, or they would receive some sort of cryotherapy in those areas. And those would be the two other options that are there to destroy the cancer as much as possible, knowing that more than likely, even after such therapy, the patients may need to have further treatment. So, for example, I'll go back a little bit to that first example of removal. If we do remove the patient's prostate and they're found to have positive margins, that individual may have to have some radiation therapy in the surrounding tissue there to destroy whatever cancer that's left behind.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed. But right now, a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, The test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed, allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.